SLBPs are master regulators that control lipid biosynthesis. This is the one that regulates fat synthesis in your body every day. SLBP usually stays in the endoplasmic reticulum within cells, right here. This is SLBP. When the body is depleted of fat or lipid, SLBP moves from the endoplasmic reticulum into Golgi complex, where it is cleaved by two proteases, site 1 protease and site 2 protease right here. The shortened SLBP is released from the Golgi membrane and migrate into the nucleus. The SLBP then binds to particular sequences in DNA and activates the bound genes to convert into messenger RNA and eventually into proteins. The SLBP binding sequences are contained in the genes that encode the enzymes involved in fat synthesis. That's why many lipid synthesizing enzymes are generated in cells to convert glucose into lipids. This pathway and the function of SLBPs were first discovered by doctors Goldstein and Brown at the University of Texas Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas. In 1985, they shared the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for their discovery in the field of lipid metabolism. Through various experiments, our research group confirmed that fatostatin blocks this activation process of SLBP. When moving from endoplasmic reticulum into Golgi complex, the SLBP is escorted by another protein called SCAP, right here. The fatostatin binds to SCAP and prevents the SLBP from migrating into Golgi apparatus. Consequently, the fatostatin impairs activation of the genes of enzymes involved in lipid synthesis. So fatostatin is a compound that stops fat synthesis at the most basic level. What happens if we inject fatostatin into experimental animals? When we injected fatostatin into an obese mouse model called OBOB mice, without injection, the mice would have continued to overeat and get really fat. When mice were treated by fatostatin, mice looked thinner, although they ate equally well. Being obese, these mice also had a fatty liver. What you are looking at here is the fatty liver. Then from the obese mice. Then if you eat too much, you get such a liver. Fatty livers were also prevented by the fatostatin injections. Nevatostatin is the first complete synthetic compound that inhibits the activation of SLBPs. That this synthetic organic compound may serve as a tool to study lipid biosynthesis and metabolic syndrome. Nevatostatin is now being sold as a research reagent worldwide. Then people can use it for biological studies. In addition, FGH10019, a more drug-like fatostatin analog, is currently being developed as a drug candidate. FGH10019 is orally available. The experiments on mice confirmed that oral administration of FGH10019 has essentially the same effect as injectable fatostatin. Then FGH10019 may become an effective treatment for severe fatty liver diseases. But by the way, I have to disclose that I'm a co-founder and scientific advisor of FGH Biotech. From the fatostatin project, I realized a university lecturer is like a mystery novel. Mystery novels structures to provide clues to the identity of a killer early in the storyline. So these clues are carefully hidden so that readers may not spot them. Only when the detective in the novel solves the mystery does the reader think, oh, there was a clue. The contents of the ethics courses you are currently taking may provide clues for the problems you will be working on in the future. Regarding SLBP, I had an opportunity to listen to a lecture by Professor Goldstein about SLBP activation process when I was in training at Harvard University. After many years, the experience at that time significantly contributed to the fatostatin finding. In the next video clip, I will tell you stories about the discovery of the surprising molecules that many of us are actually drinking every day.